So you just saw how trying to find your identity in the world, which most of us do, we're human, it doesn't work. And so now we're going to move into talking about trying to find your identity in yourself. And I'm Mike Avayone. I'm a sophomore at Model High School. And so self-identity and finding out your identity in yourself is a broad topic, but it's a very imperative, it's a very crucial topic, because knowing who you are is not a bad thing, but becoming engrossed in yourself and full of yourself is where you can go wrong. And so I want to talk to you guys today about my journey in life and how trying to find my identity in myself almost kept me from the most important thing that I have today. And I'm going to tell you guys what that is here in a minute. So as a child, my parents knew for sure this kid will never struggle with self-confidence. And so when I began to learn how to walk, I didn't just walk around everywhere. I strutted everywhere. I held my head high, I had my shoulders back, and I just started strutting everywhere. You know, most kids, you know, are trying to balance and get on their tippy toes. And once I got the hang of it, I just strutted everywhere. And so once again, being confident and knowing who you are is not a bad thing. But we began to realize I wasn't just being confident. I was starting to be cocky. I was starting to be arrogant. And so as I grew older, I began to recognize that I was an intelligent individual, from perfect scores on CRCTs as a kid in elementary school to tests in high school. And I didn't recognize that intelligence as a gift from God that I really don't deserve, a gracious gift from God that I did nothing to deserve. I began to recognize it as a quality, a perfect quality of myself that I thought I had earned. Not as a gift that I didn't deserve, but a quality of myself that I had earned. And so this progressed and it got worse and worse. And when I was about 13 years old, I began to question everything I believed. I let my confidence, my pride, my arrogance get in the way. And so growing up in church, it really ate away at me, because I knew, or I had one side of myself saying, you're too smart to believe in this. Why are you, you know, engrossed in religion? Why do you believe in this fantasy of a God? It's all a fairy tale. And then the other side of me was saying, what are you talking about? You've grown up in this. You've been taught this your whole life. You can't let that get to you. But I really started to lean towards, don't believe in this. And so one night in November, Sunday night, I'm praying. And my grandfather sees me praying, and he comes down to pray with me. And he said a verse that I've known my whole life, actually that I had memorized for Bible quiz, but I'd never thought of it. And so when he's down praying with me, he quotes Hebrews 11:1, and it says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And I want to focus on that last part, the evidence of things not seen, because when he said it, something clicked inside of me. I didn't need scientific proof of God. I didn't have to see God to know he was real. I could rely on the memorials that I had made, whether it was singing and praising God in church, whether it was connecting with a pastor as he's preaching and drawing the connection into my own life, I realized I didn't need that proof to know that God was real, that faith was my evidence. And so I want to leave you guys with this. About 3 days after my grandfather prayed with me, he underwent a massive, unexpected stroke, and 4 days later, he passed away. But if he wouldn't have passed away, I do not think that the words that he left me with would have made such an impact, because every time I think of him, I think of that message that he left me with. And so I almost missed out. This is what I was talking to you about earlier. The most important thing in my life is the relationship with God that I have today. And I almost missed out on it. But now I know that I know nothing, I have nothing, and I am nothing without God. And I can wake up every morning and I can know that I am blessed with the gifts that I have. I didn't do anything to earn them. Actually, I don't deserve them at all. And he's given them to me as a gift. And so I know that I'm in desperate need of him and that I can't do anything without him. And so I just wanted to leave you guys with that message of we are nothing, we know nothing, and we have nothing without God. And trying to find our identity in ourselves is going to lead us to a road of depression, a road of arrogance, pride, and it's not where he wants you to be.